Hi YouTubers! Today I'm going to teach you how to make a simple hydroponic setup using a plastic cup with cover. The materials you're going to use are one plastic cup, long plastic cup. In my case, I'm just recycling this from a used peanut butter, and then a nylon string or a nylon cord. Or simply cotton cord will do, a blade cutter. Children, when you're going to use something sharp like this, be sure that your parents are with you to supervise you. And then, last but not least, a scissor. The first thing you're going to do is to remove the cover or the lid, then as you can see, there is a smaller circle or the internal circle, then this is the outer circle. Then you have to separate the internal circle using a blade cutter. Just be sure that it will not damage the inner portion because you're going to use this one for the next procedure. I have pre-separated sample. As you can see, this belongs here. I used the blade cutter to remove the inner circle to produce this tube. Next is you get an ample amount of nylon string. You fold it into four. Or if you want, you can have much more. Then you tie it at that one end. This will serve as a wick for your mini hydroponic system. Like that. Next is you get the inner circle. Then you cut a slit like this using your scissor. This will hold the wick or the nylon cord like that. Okay. Next is you get the plastic cup, then make a hole, a simple hole, using your scissor. Then you do it like that until you make a hole as big as this. This will serve as a drainage, and this will serve, this part will serve as your reservoir for the water. Next thing is a tricky part. Then you have to put the lid, the cut lid, with the nylon string inside the cup. Just so, like that. Okay, this is somehow very tricky. Let's repeat it. You get another cup, then you put it like that to make it balance. See? Not reaching the hole you punch. And then that's it. That's good. Just fill this up with soil and then put the plants in. You water the plant. Then make sure that the water level reaches before the hole, like that. Then I have here one good sample with the plant. See? You can see the cord inside that serves as a wick so that the plant will not get dry. This is an arrowhead, a maroon type arrowhead. And then you can see that the hole is here so that I don't overwater the plants. I hope this is very helpful for you. So you can leave this plant unwatered for 2 weeks or so, maybe 1 week if the weather is very hot. Just leave it there. when you're going somewhere, then you just water it, reach the water up to this level, then the plant will survive for 2 weeks without you watering it. What are the other uses of this type of planter I did? Aside from growing your plants, not watering it from quite sometimes, this will also serve as a seed pot or a pot that will start seeds. How? You know that growing seeds needs a lot of humidity. All you need to do is to get one square plastic, then you put it on top, take the outer circle, and then put it on top. You pinch the plastic and then create a space so that the plant can breathe. Then you close the lid. Then that will serve as your seed holder or seed growing kit. Then the water will keep the soil moist so that the seed will survive. All you need is just ampule light. Then when the seed grows, you just remove this one, then continue growing the seed. I also use this type of planter growing my carnivorous plant. You know that they can only survive a very wet soil. So I'm growing one carnivorous plant using this planter. This is Sarracenia. And it's been growing and it's thriving using this planter. It has few good shoots over there. Then I don't need to worry about watering it every day because the wick type method serves to keep the soil very moist. And I'm watering it with distilled water. Then it's good and it's nice and it's thriving. I'm also growing plants using this pot that demands a high humidity level. This is what you call Pitonia. This cannot survive under ordinary circumstances. It needs very high humidity. And the soil must always be wet but not soggy. So I see to it that I do not overwater it and just keep the water level just more than below the punch hole. Then it's also thriving. Actually, this is just a daughter plant and I have the mother plant there. And it's been thriving and putting up so many shoots. As you can see, it's putting up so many shoots. And this is a very rare plant and I'm very happy with it. Thank you for watching my video. I hope that this project will be very, very helpful to you, especially those indoor grower. And I will give you an update with whatever I can grow with this project. God bless.